Okay, so this is starting to turn out to be a really long series. So I've gone ahead and done a couple things, and I'm going to go over that real quick with you. I've darkened this area. I've put a light wash over the flowers so that the centers aren't so white. I put a light wash down here just to kind of fill in and give it some ground in the face a little bit. And we're going to go ahead and finish this eye that we started the other day. So I'm using my Van Gogh. I'm going to start on the brown here. Just a minute, I think I've got to pull my picture up. Okay. I'm doing this real light. I have some fills in it. Put some of that back off it. Some of my gamboge yellow. My highlight in. My neutral tint. Some dark brown. I'll have the colors listed for you. I'm going to switch to a smaller brush. I put some blue in the other day when we were doing this, so that's good still. I'm just going to blend this down a little. It's too much. blood down in there where I don't want it. Pick it up a little bit. Silence here, sorry. Put some more of my neutral tint in there. And with my yellow again. Kind of muddy there. Let's try that again. All right, there we go. And then I just take a little bit of orange. Find this eye where it's real dark here. It kind of gets light in the center. I'm not going to really do that super dark there. Bit of a blue wash over it. This is kind of like a light blue in here, so I'm leaving that like it is. This is a little brighter up in here. Now this is the technique that I want to show you I use. It's almost a dry brush over the dark areas to give it texture. Oops, wrong color. This is my neutral tint. It's real dark right in here, up through here. So I just kind of, this is why I love rough texture paper, because it really makes a nice effect on pets. You know, it looks kind of crazy when I first do it. The brush off, and I just kind of knock this down a little bit with plain water. Just soften it slightly, and you get that nice kind of fur look there. the darkened area right here. I'm going to do the same thing, just kind of lightly let the paper texture work for me. I'm going to brush off and just lightly knock that down. And that's what I've done, like through these areas here. Okay, this highlight seems like a really weird color, but that was just the base. And I'm going to use some of my blue violet. Just lightly, kind of keeping, doing the same kind of a textury like finish on it. Gives it a fur look. And I mean, if that doesn't work out for you at first, just go ahead and wet it and blot it off and try again. All right. I might darken this area of these ears up just a tiny bit. With a little bit of blue to like pull it together so there's no real distinct line there. Alright, this kind of needs to dry a little bit, and we're going to go in with the gouache, white gouache. I hope I'm saying that right. I am profoundly deaf in real life, so I say things wrong sometimes because I just don't hear what they're supposed to sound like when I make it up. What I think it's supposed to be. I'm gonna do a little bit more purple over here on this highlight. Open that a little more. Okay. Yeah, I like that better. Okay. And looks like a little bit of purple tint right here would be good. I feel like I might have wet that just a little more than I wanted, and I lost the definition, so I'm just going to blot that out and probably just leave it like that. Maybe a little more. Try again. Alright, I think I'm happy with that. It gave him kind of a fur-like texture and darkened the areas that we wanted to bring out the definition. And I'm going to do a little bit of the neutral tint right here where this is dark. I just kind of dab around so that I hopefully don't lose the texture there. I think that really looks fur-like. I like how that looks right there. Okay, so now to work on the eye a little bit more. I think I'm gonna try some lemon yellow this time. I think I want that a little brighter. Uh-huh. Okay. Go with my brown again over here. A little bit of the orange mixed in that. Okay, let's see. Okay, I'm liking that. I think this is too high up right here, so I'm going to use some of my neutral tint on that area. There's quite a strong eyelid going on there, or she. Alright, and this is pretty bright. I'm going to knock it down just a tiny bit here. I'm going to be putting some white gouache up there. Okay. I've gone in and darkened this up. This is the opera rose, just like full strength here, and the headband. That'll kind of fade in a little bit. That'll work out just fine. Should be a little white right here. And I'll probably come back in that with some pink. So. Right there. It shouldn't be white here at all. That little more dimension there. Okay. And a little bit more blue up here in the white area that's put in, so. Full strength though. This sort of like fades away into it, so it's not real strong. I've taken little dots of it, as you can see, like here, and kind of given his face a little bit of texture. When I do that, I usually just hit it with my finger and knock it down. And there, like the little. Little hairs in there. Not a lot. And you can see my white has like really faded in there, so I'm going to go over that again. Mm. There's some light in this eye over in here that I'm not getting, so I'm gonna probably gonna hit that with some lemon yellow. Put a little bit of brown in that. This area. Actually, maybe some orange even. Not real strong. Let's give it a little dimension. Okay. I think I'll go in with my lemon yellow. Okay, I'm gonna do, this is probably as dry as I want it to be for the gouache up there. I just don't want this to stand out and be real white. I want it to fade in, but I want to give a little light in there. There's some light area here. See how that looks after it fades in a bit. This up here. Through here a little bit. This up so I can see what I'm doing here, if I've got it. Okay, it's a little dark over here. So I can kind of fix my mistake. I think I brought the black over there a little too far and I didn't really like that. And just put a little bit of kind of like some faint hairs in here. Those will fade back in with the dry, when it, as it dries, it's not going to be standing out like that. Sometimes I do that and then I just take like my light blue, my blue, and just kind of go over it, and it gives it a highlight there that I didn't have, and I think that kind of helps. There's some white hairs up here in this area, kind of. I mean, this is not a hyper-realistic painting, so, you know, it doesn't have to be, like, hair, and just, like, the suggestion of it there. Just a little bit of highlight. Okay. I think I'm going to fix that pink a little bit. This eye real quick. And if you get too much on and you don't like it, like I said, you can just hit it with some of your blue and it tones it down and makes it not as extreme. There we go. And I think that's it then.